Hello, my name is Nuria Dabiu and I'm a postdoctoral fellow in the lab of Dr. J.D. Baines at the Hodgkin's Brain Institute at the University of Calgary. I am from Barcelona and I have a psychology training and I pursue my PhD in the neurobiology of stress, focusing my dissertation in animal models of post-traumatic stress disorders. In 2015, I moved to Calgary to start the postdoctoral position exploring the concept of stress controllability. I was curious about how having control or perceiving control over a stressful event in your life can change your ability to face new challenges. Instead of focusing in the negative consequences caused by stress, I was more interested in unraveling how stress can be beneficial, how the brain processes specific characteristics around stress control that influence future behaviors. Our recent work published in Nature Neuroscience reveals that an enzyme population of cells in the brain, specifically the corticotropin-releasing hormones or CRH neurons in the hypothalamus that control stress hormone release, may hold the key linking stress controllability in one situation with behavior in future stressful events. We use a number of experimental approaches ranging from fiber photometry, electrophysiology, optogenetics, classical instrumental training, and an ethological model that mimics predator attack for a mouse. This model is a simple approach in which mice are exposed to an expanding shadow above them to mimic a predator approaching from the sky. We monitor the behavior and record the activity of the CRH neurons and discover that on the behavioral level, animals either escape to a shelter or froze in place when exposed to this looming shadow. When we look at the CRH activity, we observe that the escape response, but not the freezing response, was always preceded by an increase in the activity of the CRH cells, and also we were able to manipulate that behavior using optogenetics. Next, we ask whether prior stressful experience with different levels of outcome control could alter CRH neurons' activity, and by extension, the behavior of the animal. Whether an individual had control over the outcome during the stress had very different effects on those cells, specifically stress that was able to be controlled by the animal, boosted the anticipatory activity of CRH neurons in conditions where the animal had the possibility to escape. Remarkably, this effect persisted in the looming shadow test, indicating that this group of cells remembers past experience and uses information to influence future behaviors. These findings are particularly exciting, considering that people behave similarly to the study subjects. People who have experienced trauma during which they felt that they had no control, they felt helplessness, often respond to subsequent stressors more passively, making it difficult to tackle challenges. Potentially, this study shows how exposure to stress over which individuals felt they had control could be an effective rehabilitation or even preventive strategy for managing effects of stress.